Good morning, children. Let's begin with our second video of social science, lesson number 9, the freedom movement of 1857. We had studied how the people agitated or had started getting the feeling of sadness, grief, anger, etc. against the British, and how different people from different positions or designations came together, joined hands to fight against the British, and the different reasons, political reasons, social reasons, etc., which gave rise to this kind of revolt. And the important reason was the introduction of Enfield rifle in the Indian Army, which the bullets of their rifle, the cartridges of their rifle, were greased with beef and pork, cows and fat, cow's fat and pig's fat, which the soldiers refused to accept or refused to use that rifle, and so that whole battalion was dissolved. Okay, and we also saw that Mangal Pandey, he was the first one to oppose the cartridge greased with the fat of cow and pigs. As a result, the revolt began earlier than the fixed date. So these all people, as we are able to see in the first paragraph, these all, they joined hands to start a revolt against the British. But what happened, because of this introduction of Enfield rifle, Mangal Pandey, he refused to accept the rifle, and he started a revolt before the fixed date. So it disrupted the planning, and the objectives of the revolt could not be achieved. Samay se pehle hi usne revolt start kar diya, and what happened? It disrupted pura planning, usne kharab kar diya. Mangal Pandey was born in a Brahmin couple in Nagwa village of Uttar Pradesh. He joined the British Army as a soldier at rupees 7 as his salary. The Indian soldiers who had agreed to revolt wanted to wait till 31st May. Whereas 26 years old Mangal Pandey could not wait till then, he refused to follow the orders of using the Enfield rifle and challenged the British officers. Sergeant Major Hewson ordered to arrest him, but Mangal Pandey shot him. So he was a young Brahmin boy who had joined the British Army, and when he was asked to use this rifle, he could not resist the, you know, humiliation, and he could not bear that anymore, and he just shot his sergeant, his head officer. And obviously, if this will happen, what if this was their situation, was there, he shot the British officer dead, what would happen? The people, the Britishers, they would arrest him, and everywhere in the country, all the soldiers will be kept under check, so that no other soldiers again retaliate against the British. He defeated another British officer too. The Indian soldiers refused to arrest Mangal Pandey, being a Brahmin, because he was Brahmin, and we know people in those days were very much superstitious. They believed that Brahmin is supposed to be the highest class, and when he was cornered by the British soldiers, a bleeding Mangal Pandey was taken to the hospital because the British wanted to get information about the plan of the revolt from him. So these other soldiers, they refused to arrest this boy, this soldier Mangal Pandey, first of all because he was Brahmin, and because they knew that whatever he is doing was correct. As a Brahmin, he was not supposed to touch the meat itself. Forget about cow or pig. Okay. And so they ignored the orders given by the British soldiers, and Mangal Pandey was taken to the hospital because the British wanted to get information about the plan of the revolt from him. The military court pretended to run a case against Mangal Pandey on 6th April 1857. The entire proceeding was in English. He was sentenced to death at the end, but he did not divulge any information regarding the revolt to the British. He did not disclose any information. The entire procedure of the court was in English so that the Indians could not understand it. And he was sentenced to death. He was given the punishment of to be hanged till death. That's how our patriots were. He was hanged at 5:30 a.m. on 8th April. And that's how he became the first martyr of the revolt of 1857. First शहीद था अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिश इन द रिवोल्ट ऑफ 1857. दैट्स हाउ आवर पेट्रियट्स वर, हमारे देशभक्त ऐसे थे. मर गया लेकिन उसने अपने मुंह अपना मुंह नहीं खोला और ब्रिटिशर्स को कुछ भी इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं दिया रिगार्डिंग द रिवोल्ट. स्प्रेड ऑफ द रिवोल्ट एंड इट्स लीडर्स. दिल्ली एंड बहादुर शाह जफर. द सोल्जर्स रीच दिल्ली फ्रॉम मेरठ, दैट इज मेरठ, इन द मॉर्निंग ऑन 11th मे. दे कुड कैप्चर दिल्ली विद द हेल्प ऑफ द इंडियन सोल्जर्स प्रेजेंट देयर. They convinced the 80-year-old Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah Zafar to accept the leadership of the revolt. This news infused a new life in the revolt and many regions of India joined the revolt. So the first group of soldiers, they reached Delhi and with the help of Indian soldiers present there, they convinced the 80-year-old Mughal Emperor, who was Bahadur Shah Zafar, to accept the leadership of the revolt. He was their leader to fight against the British. This news infused a new life, gave a new life to the revolt, and many regions of India joined the revolt. Another is Bihar and Kumar Singh. Patna and Jagdishpur were the main centers of the revolt in Bihar. Kumar Singh, a 70-year-old landlord, see, we can see the old elderly kings also were ready to join the revolt because they thought that we have suffered so much under the leadership, under the rule of British, why should our next generation suffer? So they willingly, open-heartedly joined the revolt against the British. We saw Bahadur Shah Zafar, he was 80 years old. Then we have seen here Kumar Singh of Bihar, he was 70-year-old landlord and he was the leader of the revolt. He fought bravely against the British. During a battle, he got shot in his arm. To stop the poison from spreading into his body, he chopped his hand off from the elbow and offered it to the river Ganga. He freed Jagdishpur from the British control before he died. See how brave, martyr he was. He got shot in his arm with a gun of the British, and to stop that poison from spreading whole into his body, he chopped his hand off, apna haath cut karke, and he haath ko usne Ganga river mein baha diya, so that he could, fight more with the British. He freed Jagdishpur from the British control before he died. Jagdishpur ko azadi dilati before he died. Such was the brave king Kumar Singh. Next among the revolutionaries were Jhansi and the great warrior Rani Lakshmi Bai. We all are very much aware of the brave Queen Rani Lakshmi Bai. The Queen of Jhansi, Lakshmi Bai, was a great warrior. The Britishers did not accept her adopted son as the heir to the throne. Heir means successor. मतलब कि राजा के बाद उसका बेटा आता है थ्रोन पे, तो रानी लक्ष्मी बाई के बेटे को उन्होंने थ्रोन पे नहीं आने दिया, saying that he is an adopted son. And Dalhousie had passed a law that whichever king did not have a heir, जिनको बेटा नहीं है, तो वो adopted son को थ्रोन पे नहीं रख सकते, और ऐसे king का जिसका बेटा नहीं है, उसका वो लोग territory हत्या लेते थे. They would snatch away the territories. Whosoever king did not have any heir, did not have any son. So her adopted son was not accepted by the British as the heir to the throne. See now the sarcastic, व्यंग कैसा है यहाँ पे, कैसा सिचुएशन है. रानी झांसी जो थी, झांसी की रानी, उसका अडॉप्टेड सन, झांसी की वो क्वीन थी, उसकी मर्जी, वो अडॉप्टेड सन को वो थ्रोन पे बिठाए नहीं बिठाए, किसी और को वो थ्रोन दे दे, who are the Britishers to interfere? But this was the case. Britishers used to snatch away the territories from the Indian princes, giving one or the other excuses. This is the reason for her joining the revolt. She was one of the most skillful leaders of the revolt. She had also prepared an army of women to fight against the British. They fought bravely against the British. According to the British officials, Queen Lakshmi Bai was one of the greatest women leaders in the revolt of 1857. So even the British soldiers or British officials, they also praised her, bravery. they said that she was the one of the greatest woman leaders of the revolt. From all the soldiers, all the kings who fought against the British, they said that she was one amongst those brave warriors. We can just imagine how courageous she must have been in those days when, you know, women did not even come out of their houses for some any work. Male only used to move around for out of the houses. Women were supposed to stay inside the house, and she was the one who came out in the battlefield to fight against the British. We must have come to know that how brave and courageous she was. Next was a brave army commander, Tatya Top. Nana Sahib Peshwa had made Tatya Top the commander of Kanpur. Soon he became his trusted commander. He skillfully fought to free Kanpur, playing the role of a commander for the first time in his life. For the next 2 years, he played a major role in the revolt across the country. No one in his time had fought many battles as he did. So he became the trusted commander, and skillfully he fought to free the Kanpur. And for many, for a few other years also, he played a major role to help the revolutionaries or to participate in the revolt. No one in his time had fought as many battles as he did. He was a very young, we can say, warrior. And at that age, in that time, very less people were there, or we can say no one was there who fought as many battles as he did. Soldiers from different parts of India had joined the revolt. From North India, Bareilly, Banaras, Allahabad, Agra, Azamgarh and Gorakhpur had joined the revolt. So these were the different places which had joined the revolt of 1857. Ajmer, Nasirabad and Abu from the Rajputana and Gwalior. Mandsaur, Indore and Dhar from the central India participated in the revolt. Satara, Kolhapur, Sawantwadi, Nargarh, Dharwad etc. became active in south. So these were the different places throughout the country who had participated in the revolt. However, these centers were scattered. Scattered means they were spread throughout the country, here and there. Some places were in north, some were in south, some in east, some in central, like that. In whole of the India, these places were scattered. Revolt of 1857 in Gujarat. The 7th Battalion of the British Army broke into revolt in Ahmedabad, Gujarat in June 1857. However, it was soon halted. Dahod, Jalot and Godhra of Panchmahal witnessed the skirmishes with the British Army. That means they witnessed or they experienced what kind of exploitations the British Army did with them. The soldiers could capture government offices with the help of the natives, but were soon defeated. So the soldiers, the revolutionaries would capture the government offices with the help of natives, but soon were defeated. The Naikadas of Panch Mahal continued the rebellion almost for a year. So this kind of battle of the revolutionaries against the British, we can see that there was no battlefield exactly, but this kind of battle against the British, it continued, and people came out with banners and directly they wanted to go against the British. And this rebellion continued for almost a year from Panch Mahal. Garbar Das Patel, the headman of Anand in Kheda district, collected almost 2,000 volunteers of the Koli and Naikada communities to join the revolt. He was supported by Jivbhai Thakur of Kanpur, Malaji Joshi and Krishna Das Dave. However, the supporters of Garbar Das were captured by the Britishers, tied to the cannon and were blown off with a cannonball fire. Garbar Das was exiled to Andaman where he died. So all these revolutionaries who participated in the revolt one or the other way, they were captured by the Britishers sometime earlier or sooner or later, and then they were sent to different jails. Like Garbar Das, who was the head then of Anand, he was exiled, he was sent to prison in Andaman. where it was supposed to be kala pani ki saza by the Britishers, and he died there. The people of Chanda village, which is 16 miles away from Eder, accepted the leadership of Nadji and Yamaji and joined the revolt. The British had camped at Nandana village between Okha and Bardi. The British commander of navy became impatient and he reached the fort of Bet Dwarka via the Bay of Bet. Donovan ordered an attack on the fort. The Baghas inside the fort had no such artillery to counter the attack. So they had no other way but to just rush out from that fort. At this time, the Wagher women came up with a very brave and innovative idea. They soaked the mattresses with water in which they could catch the cannon balls and cool them immediately. So the Britishers, when they captured the fort and the people hiding inside the fort, they had to run out from that fort to save their lives. And they started blowing cannons on these people, on these revolutionaries. At that time, the Wagher women, they had a very innovative idea. They soaked the mattresses, mattress jo hoti hai hamari, usko pani mein bhiga diya pura, and whichever cannons, jo top mein se cannon nikal ke inke upar barsa rahe the fort mein se Britishers, British army, wo is mattress mein usko catch kar de rahe the, so that wo cannon jo garam garam hote the aur tabahi macha sakte the like a bomb, they immediately cooled down. This would enable the Wagher men to fight the battle without being hit by the cannon balls. So in this way we can see how the people with innovative ideas could face the Britishers, the British army. Nowhere in the history of the world such act of valor has been exhibited. Nowhere in the history we can see such kind of bravery. Wagher women very bravely disarmed the cannon balls without worrying about their own lives. They were not worried ki agar wo cannon ball hamare upar girega to hum mar sakte hain, but they showed their act of bravery. Their act of bravery was equivalent of that of Rani Lakshmibai. These women were the Lakshmibais of Gujarat. So children, hope you understood the video till now. We will continue the chapter in the next video. So children, hope you understood the chapter till now. We will continue further in the next video. Thank you everyone.